Hello everyone, I am here to present Social Networking Analysis Report. I am Punit agarwal, a Y16 student at LNM IIT. So this is the project that we have done in the Social Network Analysis course under Dr. Sakthi Balan Mutya. And like in this particular project, we have analyzed the dataset of Orkut and Twitter. So the dataset that we have chosen was social network of Orkut, and it was basically the social network of Orkut users and their connections. The properties of edges in the dataset was the edges were indirect and the edges were unweighted. Also, the diameter is of 10 edges. The complete dataset had a size of around 3 million vertices, and it had a volume of around 117 million edges. The average degree of the dataset was 70 edges per vertex, where each vertex represents a user. In the sample database and dataset, the size that we got as a sample was around 549 vertices with a volume of 1925 edges. The average degree was 7 edges per vertex. So the dataset has been taken from the Max Planck Institute for Software Systems, that is IMC 2007 paper, and the process of sampling, like the pre-processing that we have done on the dataset was to randomize it. So what we have done basically is we have filtered out all the nodes which were between 7000 to 8000 using a Python code. So this was done so as to get a more representative dataset. Like as we can see here, this is the graph that we have generated from the dataset that we have picked up. So initially what we did was we imported various libraries, that is NetworkX, Matplotlib and math. Apart from this, like we have initialized the matplotlib and we have read the graph from all the list of edges that was in the dataset. So sample.txt is what we named the dataset. After that, we have printed the information about graph and we have drawn it. So after drawing it, this is basically the graph that we get. So here the red color are the edges and the green color are the vertices. Apart from it, we then found the centralities. So we have found degree centrality, in degree centrality, and then betweenness, out degree, cards. So we have found various varieties of centrality. So let's come on how we did it. So coming to degree centrality, so we have used the direct function that is available on NetworkX, that is d is equals to nx.degree_centrality, and we have printed. Then we have used the draw function of matplotlib and we have generated the graph. So as you can see, this is the degree centrality of the dataset that we had, wherein the first five values are as such. Next we found in degree centrality, which is again using the library of NetworkX. And after that we have found out degree and betweenness. After that we have found eigenvector centrality and then we have found Katz centrality. So in all of these we have used the algorithms that is provided directly by NetworkX, and we have used the functions. We have put our graph, we have put the graph that was generated by randoming the entire dataset, and we have uploaded it. So therefore, card centrality, we basically used a variable called phi and we defined it as 1 plus under root 5 upon 2.0, which is basically the value of phi. And then we found the value of k, that is card centrality, as nx.cardcentrality_numpy, and we have passed the variables h and 1 upon 5 minus 0.01. So this is what we got the card centrality. Then this is the degree of card centrality, and we have eventually found page rank centrality as well. So this is what we got at page rank centrality. Now coming to closeness centrality, closeness centrality was also found, and like for this we used the draw function again of matplotlib, and we have printed the values. So the first five values are again printed, as there was a lot of values that could not be accommodated into the report. We have printed just a sample of values. So we have also found the clustering coefficient, and like for clustering coefficient, we have found the average clustering, and this is for the global one. For the local one, we have found the NX clustering method. We have used the NX clustering method and we have drawn the graph for it. So we have also find the transitivity to determine whether like the graph is does the graph demonstrate the transitive behavior or not. And the value of transitivity that we got is of 0.026166. We have also found the reciprocity, like that is a measure of likelihood of vertices in a directed network to be mutually linked. So we came to know with the reciprocity that came around 0.0. Apart from that, like the basic inference of applying all of the centrality measures on the Orkut dataset, we infer that eigencentrality is best measure to measure the centrality of Orkut. We mention this because eigencentrality is a good score and it's handy for understanding human social networks, but also for understanding like malware propagation. So coming to like this was the basic reason that we found eigencentrality is the best measure to best method to measure the centrality for Orkut dataset. Now coming to second dataset that we have applied for the same algorithms is for Twitter database. So the properties of the edges are the edges are directed, the edges are unweighted, and the diameter is of 23 edges. The link to the dataset has been provided here, which is being the dataset has been downloaded from Connect. The size was 41 million vertices and the volume was 1 billion edges. Apart from that, the average degree was 70 edges per vertex, whereas each vertex represents an user. So we have applied random sampling on this database, on this dataset, and like we have used the function of chef minus n 1000, and we have found this particular file, and we like this was the original dataset, and we shortlisted 1000 random datasets among from these, and we have saved them in a new file named .txt. So the dataset that we got after random sampling it was of size of 3000 vertices and 1500 edges. The average degree is 1.027, and like the entire network was the follower network from Twitter that contained 1.4 billion directed follow edges and 41 million Twitter users. The source of dataset was Proceedings of 19th International World Wide Web Conference that was held on April 26 to 30th in 2010. So this is basically the directed graph that we got. So this is the entire graph that consists of around 1500 vertex, and it consists of 3000 vertices and 1500 edges. The average degree is 1. So for this we have again used the import functions, and we have drawn the graph. We have applied the various centrality measures as discussed above, that is degree, in degree, out degree, betweenness, cards, page rank, transitivity, a lot more. So we have discussed all of these centralities before. We have applied the same algorithms on this dataset as well. Now coming to the closeness centrality clustering coefficient. Coming to the clustering coefficient. So the global clustering coefficient for this particular values for this particular dataset was almost zero. Like we found around 0.010010002. This is because the graph was very short part of the entire dataset, which was a massive, huge 41 million vertices. But we just have around 1500 to 3000 vertices. So this is the reason that the values are very less. The local clustering coefficient, however, it's better. We have like the first five values are this, and the graph generated can be seen here. Apart from this, the transitivity was zero, reciprocity was zero as well. So like we found the best centrality measure out of all the centrality that we have found, or all the centralities that we have approached, and basically all the centralities that we have applied on the dataset, we found that the degree centrality is best measured to measure the centrality of Twitter. This is because degree centrality is used for finding very connected individuals, proper individuals, individuals who are likely to hold most information, or individuals who can quickly connect with the wider network. In short, like, it basically helps us to find influencers, and Twitter basically works on influencing. So we need to find the influencer nodes, and we thought that degree centrality is the best measure to measure the centrality of Twitter dataset. Now I'd like to hand over this to one of my team members, that is Ashish.
All right. Hello everyone. I am Ashish Gupta. I am from LNM IIT, and this is the second round of our project. So basically, we have two questions. One is try to get an algorithm package in Python to find the maximum connected component, that is called also joint component. In a given graph G, let us denote the number of nodes in the joint graph of a graph G as Nd. Calculate our maximum of connected component, and the nx dot road is draw our graph. And second question is for the problem given in homework 5, this is our homework on Piazza. Vary k from 0 to 5 with an increment of 0.1. For each value of k, find the ratio ngn, where n is the number of nodes in the graph. Plot the ratio with the average k and average k with the ng by n. So we start here. Firstly, we imported the required Python dependency like networkx and matplotlib.pyplot, and then we declared all the required arrays. Here our node array store the number of nodes in the maximum connected component of the arrays. Average k store the value of the average degree from 0 to 5 with the increment of 0.1. Node wise, store the value of ng by n. So this code is also shown as declare all the required array. Then we plotted the graph for all values of k between 0 to 5 incremented with 0.1 using the Erdos Renyi graph function. This is the algorithm of our project of using the networkx library, found the maximum connected component of the each graph, which is denoted by GC. This code is basically it's just a for loop which is running 0 to 500. This is 500. 500 means our expected node, and x by 5000 is our probability, which is depends upon I, which is for which coming for the for loop. And then we draw, and GC is the maximum connected component, and then print, append, and then draw. Now after that, we store average value from 0 to 5 with the increment of 0.1 and print them to check if they were correct or not. For then we start a loop 0 to 50 and divide by 10 and store in the array with the increment of 0.1, and then we check it is correct. Finally, we will plotted the graph with the average degree k and x-axis and the ng by n of the y-axis, also given as the title the plot as evolution of random network. This code x-axis is the given the label, and ng by n is a y-axis, and plot title evolution of the random network, and then we plot average k and node by m, and then show here we store the value of our ng by n, and this is the node array I divided by 500, which is ng by n because 500 is our n, and then we multiply it 1 because we because we found the value in we want to get the value in float variable, and this is the final graph over ng by n and the average degree.
Hello, my name is Tushar Bansal and I am a pre-final student at the LNM Institute of Information Technology. So today we will be discussing about third round of the project, which is basically applying community detection algorithm on original network using our original data set. So the community detection algorithm can be classified into two, which is first group-based community detection, which basically focuses on detecting community that are balanced, dense, etc. So first we will be discussing about hierarchical community detection, and the algorithm which we'll be using is Grevan-Newman's algorithm, and which is a divisive algorithm. So first we have computed the Grevan-Newman algorithm, and we have clustered the community and we have stored it in the community variable, COMP variable, and then we have printed the length of the community, which is of the size 10. And then we have sorted the community and printed the community, and it gives us 10 communities of different sizes. Next we will be discussing about modularity maximization. Greedy modularity maximizations begin with each nodes in its own community, and then it joins the pair of community that increases modularity most until no such pair exists, right? So first we will create a list of the greedy of the output of greedy modularity communities, which is stored in C, and then we have printed the length of the community, that is how many communities are found, and we have found that there are 10 communities, and then we have sorted the communities and we have printed the communities that are as shown below in the images. Then we have used balanced based clustering. In balanced based clustering, what we have done is we have clustered the algorithm, we have clustered the community in two parts, that is the members which belong to one group are classified as 1, and the member which belong to other group are classified as 0. So we have imported the NumPy library and scikit-learn cluster, which is importing the spectral clustering algorithm, and then we have built the adjacency matrix for this graph, which is stored in adj_mat, and then we have applied the spectral clustering algorithm, and which and the output is stored in sc, and we have printed the labels. So it's given 1111 and other are 0. So the members classified as 1 are in one community, and the members classified as 0 are in another community. Next we have used member based community detection. In members based community detection, we basically focuses on the on grouping members on basis of their characteristics and attributes, right? So members with same characteristics are classified in one group, and we have used clique percolation algorithm, and we are clustering the members on the basis of their degree, that is members with same degree are clustered into one community. So what we have done is we have applied K-click communities algorithm, and we have stored that in C, right? We have created the list, and the list is stored in C variable, and we have found that using the click of 4 size, that is maximum click of 4 size, the number of clicks we got are 7, and we have then printed the list, and the list is shown as below. So next what we have done is we have found that the clustering algorithm gives average communities that are of 11, and we have used k as 5 in clique percolation method. The output is shown as the list above. Then for the second data set,
so now we will be applying community detection algorithm on our second data set, which was of Twitter. So initially, as Punit told, the dataset was of very huge length, and the dataset was very big. So we compressed it, and then we applied Greven-Newman's algorithm, which was a hierarchical based detection, and which was divisive algorithm. So first we have computed the Grivan-Newman's algorithm on a graph G, and then we have stored the output in CUMP variable, and then we have sorted the clusters, and we have printed the length, and the output is as shown below. The output the number of communities are of size 950. That are 950 communities were detected. This number is large because the data set which after pre-processing the main data set, we have got many nodes which were just connected to one other nodes. So they were scattered nodes, right? There were many disconnected components in that. So that's why we have increased number. There is an increased number of communities in this. Secondly, we have applied a K-Clique algorithm, and in this we have stored the result of the list in C, and then we have printed the list, and we have used the k value as 2 because there were many disconnected components of 2, right? So that's why we have used k value of 2, and the output gave us a size of 950. So it was same as of Grivan-Newman's algorithm. So now next we will be discussing about spectral clustering algorithm, which basically classifies the communities into two parts, zero and one. That is, one community is classified as zero, another community is classified as one, and the output is shown here. And first we have generated a adjacency matrix for the graph, and as shown in, and we have stored the adjacency matrix in adj_mat. Next, what we have done is greedy modularity algorithm. We have applied the algorithm on the graph G and stored the result on C, and we have sorted, and for the first and we have shown the result for the first community, that is C0. That means 0 is telling that it's the first community. If we have put C1, that will be showing our first community. So for the zeroth community, the output is shown as below, and the inference that we got from this is that the community are of mostly size 2, and there were many communities of about 950 communities were there. Thank you.